أستغفر الله من ذنبي ومن زلالي.
This is a month that the beginning of it is rahmah, mercy. And the middle of it is maghfirah, forgiveness. And the end of it is being saved from hellfire. Jibreel alayhi salam, Aminu wahy al-sama, came to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The number one human being that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has ever created. And he said, Ya Muhammad, O Muhammad, raghima anfuh. May his nose be placed in the dirt, meaning may he be humiliated. May he be embarrassed. May he lose so much. What a loser. رَغِمَ أَنْفُهُ ثُمَّ رَغِمَ أَنْفُهُ ثُمَّ رَغِمَ أَنْفُهُ May he be humiliated. May he be humiliated. May he be humiliated. Allahu Akbar. Who fits this description, Ikhwani? What would Jibreel alayhi salam ask Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to make dua, to say ameen on his dua? So the Prophet alayhi salam said, Ameen. So Jibreel alayhi salam said, May he be humiliated. رَغِمَ أَنْفُهُ ثُمَّ رَغِمَ أَنْفُهُ ثُمَّ رَغِمَ أَنْفُهُ الَّذِي بَلَغَ رَمَضَانَ The man or the woman, the servant of Allah, who reaches Ramadan and doesn't get all their sins forgiven. So the Prophet sallallahu alayhi salam said, Ameen. Some people, إخواني, in Ramadan, spend so much watching TV, Facebook, MSN, phone, anything, just entertainment. They want to kill the time. They don't know that it's their own lives that they're killing. They don't know that it's their own Ramadan that they're killing. How can you be sure that next Ramadan you're going to be sitting here? Didn't you know that there were people sitting here last year? They're not sitting here with us this year. They're 6 foot under. How can you be so sure that you're going to be here again, Ikhwani? Treat it like it's like your last Ramadan. How can you be sure that next year you're not going to be on a on crutches or in a hospital bed or in a nursing home or whatever it is. How can you be so sure? It could be your very last Ramadan, akhi. What do you do with it? Ikhwani, Ramadan, apart from the food and the water and the dates and the little calendars that we see everywhere and the little iftars that we're getting invited and we can't fit them on our schedules, Ramadan is a month of forgiveness from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So much that Jibreel alayhi salam was making dua that you may be humiliated if you reach Ramadan and you don't lose all your sins. That all your sins don't get forgiven. You must be on a mission to maintain these sins. You must be holding on to your sins so much if you don't want Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to forgive you, especially in Ramadan. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the hadith al-Qudsi, Ya Ibn Adam, إنك ما دعوتني ورجوتني غفرت لك ما كان منك ولا أبالي O son of Adam, so long that you call on to me and you ask me for forgiveness, I'll forgive you and I do not care. O son of Adam, if your sins reach the doors of the heavens and you ask me for forgiveness, I'll forgive you. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, your sins will reach the doors of the heavens and you ask him for forgiveness and he'll forgive you. What more do you want, akhi? لو بلغت ذنوبك عنان السماء يا ابن آدم لو لقيتني يوم القيامة بقراب الأرض خطايا ثم لقيتني لا تشرك بي شيئا للقيتك بقرابها مغفرة Oh son of Adam, if you come to me on the day of judgment with the earth, see earth, full of sins and you come bearing witness that there's no deity worthy of worship except for me. You bearing witness that there's no God except for Allah. You seek his forgiveness. للقيتك بقرابها مغفرة أو forgive all your sins. إخواني, the difference between you and getting repentance and forgiveness from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying, Ya Rabbi اغفري. Oh Allah, forgive me. Wallahi al-azim, that's how easy it is. The difference between you and repenting from that sin is saying, Oh my Lord, forgive me from that sin.
أستغفر الله من يوم أولي